Okay, well, let's take a look at how this actually works within this AF user interface. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new element template. I'm going to create a, recirculation pump. So it's just going to be a real simple template. It's only going to have two attributes, and the attributes are going to be real straightforward. We'll just call them attribute 1 and attribute 2. I'm not even going to bother giving these names at this point. So for purposes of this demonstration, I'll go ahead and check these in. For purposes of this demonstration, that's what we're seeing. Attribute 1 and attribute 2, part of the recirc pump. And let's go ahead and create now. I won't put this in here. Let's just add this recirculation pump as part of our equipment maintenance. I'll do a new child element. I'm going to choose the recirc pump. And there it is. So it's called recirc pump 1. As you can see in the initial, incarnation of this, it has a version 1 and a revision 0. Hasn't been revised at all. I'm sorry, I said that wrong earlier. I said that was going to show up as revision 1. Yeah, there we go. So it's version 1, revision 0. Haven't done anything with it yet at this point. Now, if I were to go in and start modifying these attributes right now, that's actually not going to have any effect on the versions. And that's because these attributes are not configuration items. That was the caveat I mentioned earlier. I said this really only affects this if you're editing a configuration item. Now, by configuration item, what we mean is, is this an attribute when their value change, it actually represents a revision. So let me go ahead and give this name. So for example, if this were a recirculation pump, and let's look at the diameter. Yeah. So if I were, now the diameter is something that would obviously be a configuration item. If that value were to change, then that's certainly a revision. So that would be something I'd want to set up as a configuration item. Now compare that to the, let's say we configured this as the flow. And I'm not going to go through the full configuration here. The flow would be probably a data reference to a Pi point, of course, or a relational database. I'll check this in. So among these two, diameter and flow, which one would be the configuration item? Well, obviously, diameter, because the flow is expected to change. You're always going to be changing the flow value. So every time the value of the flow changes, we don't want to configure a new revision. Now, right now, neither of these are configured to be revisions, or to be configuration items, I should say. So watch what happens if I were to go in and make a change to the diameter. Oh, let's say this is currently at 5. I'll go ahead and save that. If we look at the version, that's actually coming back as revision 1 now. But watch what happens as I make changes to it. Let's go with 8. I'll go ahead and check this in. Yeah, notice the revision stays the same, no matter how many times I change it. Now, once we have populated that, and now it doesn't matter how many times I make this change, that's not a configuration change. And every time I make that change, it does not increment anything. The version's still the same, the revision's still the same. Now, if I were to change that, and by the way, the same is true for this other. If I change the flow, let's say the flow is 50 units, I'll check that in. That does not increment the version or the revision at all. And the reason for that is because neither of these are configured as these configuration items. So I'll go ahead and change that. I'm going to change diameter. I'm going to say that's a configuration item. Go ahead and check that in. Now watch what happens now when I go back into my element here. Here's my recirculation pump. I'll go in and change. I say, well, the diameter, it's not 12, it's actually 10. I'll go ahead and check that in. And when I check this in this time, notice the version is now incrementing, because what we're doing is we're making a change to a configuration item. If it's 11 feet, check that in. Now that's going to be revision number 3, still on version number 1. And maybe this is the obvious, but watch if I change this to, say, 55 and check that in, that's not going to increment this, because remember, that's still, that is not a configuration item. That attribute is expected to change. So if I keep changing that, that doesn't increment the version or the revision. So that explains the behavior of this revision. What about version? How do we increment version? Well, as you can see, right here within version, you can create a new version this way. You can also, from anywhere in this configuration, you can do a right mouse click and choose Create Version. So if I choose to create a new version, the effective date is going to, well, it's defaulting to the current time. I can go ahead and create this, add a comment, say, okay, this is, you know, we've made a change here that we want to preserve. And when you do that now, and check this in, you'll notice the version number has now incremented. We're back to revision 1, but now we're on version 2. Now later on, I'll show you how to change the query date so that we can go back and look at the history. See, if I go in now and I change these, let's say the diameter, let's cut both of these in half. Let's say we're going to go to 5. This is going to be 22. I'll go ahead and check this in. Now that is going to increment the revision, because remember, one of the configuration items has changed. It doesn't store the history of the revision, but it just indicates that that has been revised. And now we're looking at version 2. Later on, we'll talk about showing the history, how you can go back and retrieve what the previous values were. If I want to go back and look at 11 and 44, I'd have to go back and look at the history. Now, one last point I'd like to make about the difference between the configuration items and the non-configuration items. Remember, this is a configuration item. A diameter was a configuration item. The flow was not. One last thing. Watch what happens if I make a change to this configuration item and then choose check-in. If I make a change to that and then choose check-in, I get this dialog box. And the dialog box, it's basically indicating to me that there's been a change that is significant enough that we have the option at this point to create a new version. And basically, it's just warning me that there's a change to a configuration item. Let me cancel out of that change. So I canceled out of my check-in. Actually, let me just go ahead and complete that. I'll go ahead and check that in. Now watch what happens, though, if I change this item. If I change that and then check it in, I don't get that dialog box. And the reason I don't get that dialog box is, again, because it's not a configuration item. This is something that, no matter how many times I change it, I'm not going to force that revision. And so we don't consider it critical enough to, you know, require a warning to you that you're about to change this configuration item. So again, you know, the fact that when I check one of these in, we get the dialog, but we don't when it's not a configuration item, is something to keep in mind. Now you'll notice later on when we do our exercise, we're counting on this to be able to create a new version. By the way, I just wanted to add too, for some of you who may be just really weary of this dialog box that keeps coming up, you may have already checked this only show database check-in dialog when shift key is down. So that will actually change the normal behavior that we were seeing, where we see this dialog box. Yeah, that's also something that's available from tools options, only show database when the shift key is down. So when you're doing this exercise, if you're not sure how your system's configured, you know, then just hold down the shift key when you do a check-in. And then no matter how it's configured to default, you will get this dialog box. And that will appear when you edit one of those configuration items.